Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I am just starting here to show you that I was able to update, I was able to upload and apply the patch to version 1.04. 0.0540. Whatever that's about. It was recently, I think it was a couple days ago, that they actually put it up on GOG.com, which is where I got the game. So I've been playing, the first two episodes were at version 1.02, 0508, and I updated twice to version 1.03, and now I get 1.04. So anyway, fixes a whole bunch of bugs, changes some things, mostly bugs. So anyway, I don't like continue for some reason. I never trust it's going to continue where I want it, you know, from where I want it to be. Yeah, I was playing at 6 something in the morning. So. Yeah. Battle music starting up. It's all traumatic and stuff. Okay. I did find out what to do. As far as potions, I'm used to, like, Baldur's Gate and Planescape Torment, more Planescape Torment, because I played it recently. You can actually consume items from within the inventory menu. In this game, you can't. You have to put it in your quick items. It seems rather limiting, but so there's a potion of minor endurance and a potion of minor regeneration, so bloop, bloop. So that's what you do there. And then you can come up here.
Yeah.
Yeah. And here they are. You can view them still and details about them, and you can only take that in combat. Now I did see something else. This is as a result of the bracer that we're wearing. Or ring, actually, sorry. I'll let you read that because I read it last time. So anyway, I was wondering what the... I wish I wouldn't keep moving over when I hit the edge like that. So this is the effect we get from that. We can use it twice, then we can't use it again until we have to rest. 16.8 endurance. Restores a moderate amount of endurance to the wearer each time it is used. So that's what we wanted to use last time. But I just didn't know what the ring was for, really. How to use it. So now because we're wearing it, it's in our quick stuff. Let's get out of that. I'm not sure what this is. Really not. And these different weapon sets.
What you need?
And I was looking through here. I didn't realize Kalisha actually has this knockdown. She can use it twice for every encounter. Shoves an enemy with enormous force, knocking them prone, but causing little damage. Of course, if you knock someone prone, does it even cause damage to her?
What you need?
I'm going to reload after doing this anyway, but... it did cause her some damage. How long it takes her to get up. So, meantime, you're wailing on them like that. I have some really hot cocoa. So anyway. That back.
No problem.
Now that we have that, I say we should run back to camp. I really do want to explore this. I'm afraid we're going to be leaving this area once we get to them, but we've got to help them in the fight here. can't get through this way, can I? Oh, I like the little circles here. Oh boy. Glamfellen Hunter. So let's try this out right away. Knock down on him.
Hmm?
So if this works... Oh boy, there's more than one. Okay, this guy's in front. Can we belay that order?
Hmm?
Glamfellen Huntress. Alright, let's use this. Blah. Okay, that is that. Okay. Allied target. Okay, so I'm gonna cast it on my ally. Soul Shock. Let's check it out. Well, I didn't see her knock anyone over. Let's not waste it on this one who's already dead. Can I undo that? Can I unselect? I don't know. I don't know how to belay the order. Cancel? Oh, there we go. I just want to say, give me some time. Be patient with me, guys. I'm learning this kind of as I go along. I'm not really practicing anything. So, I mean, I have read through the manual. But as far as the detailed stuff like this, you learn by doing. So, give me some time to... Alright. So now I do want to use the knockdown here. My spells are done. Yeah, I can't use spells. Okay. Rapier. What am I doing? Oh. Okay.
What you need?
I need you to knock me down if you can. Cool. See how long it takes me to get up? Oh, we're doing all that damage. Awesome. So we're pretty much okay. Let's loot the bodies. Now here's what we find out about encumbrance, I'm sure. Medium shield. Moderate improvement in protection with a small reduction to accuracy. They are most commonly used shields in a deer wouldn't come in a variety of types. Maybe I can sell this to the tradesman, the merchant, if he's not dead. Hide armor, 10 copper. And that's for both of them? Okay. A hunting bow. Extremely popular in the Deerwood and Ear Glanfath, though used most frequently for hunting deer and small game, hunting bows can be deadly against two-legged prey. Hunting bows lack the high draw weight of war bows, but can be fired more quickly. More hide armor and 10 gold. I'm guessing that's gold. Yeah, they're teaching us a limited number of uses. Times per encounter and times per rest. We have to get camping supplies.
Sure.
Both of us. Oh boy. slaughtered people. Oh boy. Glamfellen leader. All around you lie the massacred remains of the other travelers, peppered with arrows and knife hilts, splayed and bug-eyed and filthy. Kalisha puts the back of her left hand to her mouth as if to ward away some poisonous vapor. I hope we're going to survive this, guys. We've already used up our spells and our special knockdown stuff. A handful of dark figures stands above the fallen, treading on limbs and backs and heads, jerking their axes from bodies as if from half-split logs. One of them, towering and severe, with a thick beard tasseled with knots, holds a wet blade at the neck of the man you recognize as Hirdan, the last of your caravan left standing. Well, I doubt diplomacy will work at this point. Lay down your arms, trespasser. Do not forfeit this man's life for a fight you will lose. Why have you done this? We have not trespassed. We might not get a chance to say all this. We might only get a chance to say one. I don't know what they did. Okay, so we're going to pretend... Some of these answers are going to pretend we're not from them. We're not from the party. Is that why they're attacking? They think that we've sullied the ruins. They think, yeah. So I'm going to choose that. My lore skill. I wanted some lore just to, you know, information about the area and stuff. Areas that we go to. The ruin has not been sullied by our hands, men of Erglanfath. Your words carry no weight when I have seen the truth with my own eyes. Blood must be paid for this intrusion. Oh boy. So I say again, lay down your arms. Oh my god, look at all these ones that we can't choose with perception. I don't think aggression is going to work. I mean, I know there's two of them. There's one here as well. Well, there's one here. And who knows up here? I can't see. So we got at least four of them. Let's try not to bluff them with aggression. So I'm going to take those right out. I'd say it's between putting down the weapons and this Intellect 15 choice. Yeah, I'm going to do this. Of course, this is probably the last time he's going to tell us to lay down the weapons. So, using our Intellect 15, judging by the string of animal teeth around your neck, I am guessing you are worshippers of Galloween. If Galloween told you to stop protecting the ruins, would you? The man frowns and motions as if to swing his axe. Hirdan winces, but the blow never comes. Instead, the man cocks his head, intrigued. Of course. But he would not. It is by the command of all the gods that we accept this charge. How do you know? Because it's consistent with their beliefs, or because it's what you were told? The man glares. It has always been known to my people. I see. And what of Galloween's edict that weakness and age must be purged by youth and strength? You think Galloween would want some moldy, crumbling stones to survive long after their boulders have turned to dust? I'm hoping I'm convincing him, because I'm not really sure what the hell I'm talking about. The man's nostrils flare as he fumes. He would not. He told us otherwise. I'm sure he did. Just not you personally. But why should that stop you from killing innocents? Oh boy, that didn't work. Distracted, the man's grip falters on his axe handle and he nearly fumbles it, affording Hirdan the moment he needs to dodge out of the swing, which comes too late. Howling with rage, the man charges you instead. Oh, crap. Should we just run? There's so many of them. Oh, well, this is Hirdan. Oh, Hirdan's in our party. He's got a potion of minor regeneration. He has 3 lockpicks. He's wearing leather armor. And he has twin daggers. Can I give these to him? This is probably cheating. I mean, this shouldn't work, right? 10 to 14 slash. Oh, the daggers are just as well. Whoops, what did I do? I'm not sure I should mess with his dual wielding here. Oh, that's all our stuff. Okay, never mind. So this is the stash for everybody, I'm guessing. Seems like. You should probably take that. So it's 3 against 4. Look at all the question marks. Hunter, hunter. Maybe if we just take down the leader, maybe the hunters will run or give up or something. I mean, that often happens. Yeah, I know that. Okay, so he's already someone hurt. Does he have anything special? Ooh, Blinding Strike. A dirty attack that makes the opponent unable to see, inflicts extra damage, and blinds the target. Hell yeah, Hiodan. Blinded for 10 seconds. Yeah. I see no reason to save that or hold on to that for any reason. So, as far as she's... Oh, per encounter. Per encounter, so she can knock him down. Forgot about that. I say cast on Hiodan. If these two move in on him, he'll hit all of them. Ha! Ha!
Ha! How can I help?
Oh boy. Cast it. Oh, did we get rid of the leader already? Okay, this guy. Second knockdown on him. Let's get rid of him. Everyone focus on this guy. Oh, well, there you go. Well, no, he's down. That's right. Oh, now he's dead. This is going a lot better than I thought it would. Hey. Your enemy lies supine on the ground, unable to rise. His companions now silent among the other dead. His breath comes in wheezing, fitful gasps. He looks not at you, but at the sky above you.
Forgive us.
Barely audible beneath his choked sighs, a whisper of wind stirs the air. Neat. At this, the man's eyes roll back as he closes them.
Good, good. The gods are just.
A queer smile crosses his face.
I am ready.
The wind begins to swell, whipping around the camp, electric and volatile, upending pots and rattling tents like an angry spirit. You can feel it begin to seep beneath your skin, and where it pierces you, it feels as though it is rending you apart from within. Okay, I'm not liking this. Oh, it's a caravan master. Seated against a wagon wheel amidst a howling maelstrom slashed across chest and bowel, Odima's body stirs, and with great effort he raises his sagging head, his eyes barely open. He looks directly at you.
Get inside! Run!
Whoa. Awesome. What the hell's gonna happen, guys? Straining against a gale that threatens to pull you off your feet with every step, you set your hands in the worn folds of weathered rock and set about pulling yourself up the precipice. With a last burst of energy before your arms give out, you swing yourself up onto the ledge. I thought we were trying to get inside. Inside is all the way up there. Heodan trails behind, slowed by injury and delayed by early hesitation. As he nears the face of the rocks, one of the fallen attackers, who had been feigning death, lunges for Heodan and topples him onto the rocky ground. Feigning death? He cheated. Restrained, Heodan lashes out against his fatigued assailant, but struggles to break his hold. They are close to you. Despite the wind from your position, if you were to throw your weapon at the attacker, you would have a good chance at hitting your mark. Oh my god, I don't have the dexterity requirement. Says I would have a good chance. Are we rolling the dice with this one, or is this a given? Throw your weapon at the attacker. Your aim is true, and the hit jars Heodan loose. Lurching to his feet, Heodan clambers up the base of the rocks. As he nears the top, however, the wind flares, pulling him sideward and tearing one of his hands free. Well, he's got that potion. I want that. But diving out onto the hard rock, you manage to catch hold of it. Securing his other hand, you pull with waning strength, and it feels as though your arms will be jerked from their sockets. They hold just long enough for Heodan to set his feet and join you on the trembling ledge. There is a deep resonance to the swelling wind now. You feel it in the rocks beneath your feet and inside the cavity of your own chest as though it would shake the marrow from your bones. Each new gust menaces the old stones before you, loosening connections, unsettling balances. As you dart beneath the old archway, the entire portal begins to fall beneath its own weight. Smaller and faster weapons tend to have a lower interrupt rating, but attack with higher frequency. New map discovered.
That? A Buick. Had to be.
Heodan's words come from between wisping gasps.
Then we're lucky to be alive.
And we're the only ones.
We can't stay here. There could be another collapse. We're not getting out that way anyway. Let's get further inside.
Sounds like a good idea. We gained experience. Quest completed. Moment's respite. See, I wanted to explore that area, but it just didn't fit into the story. Hold on. Oh, we don't get... Wait a second. Ah. Quest added the ruins of Silentlis. Got updated quests. I want to see what it said. New map discovered Silentlis. 30 XP earned, okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. A lower level of the ruins has been blocked off by fallen rubble.
No problem.
Hmm. I'm gonna take this out for now. I don't find that it doesn't go with the atmosphere of the game.
That should be far enough. But what now?
Hiodan's chest rises and falls visibly with each breath.
We look for another way out. Storm has to die sometime.
What happened out there? Kalisha shakes her head. Windstorm. Of a kind they only get in Ir Glamfath. Not too many people live through them, so it's hard to know what's true. The Glamfathan word is Beowick. To them, it's the god's way of reaping the souls of the land that couldn't find their own way out. But they'll take a living soul as soon as a dead one. Still got yours? What do you think? Who attacked us? Glamfathans. Those would be the hut dwellers Odima warned you about. Look to be fangs of Galloween, who are the twitchiest of the lot. They go ruin to ruin, looking for fights with colonists. Poor Odima. I think he half expected this once we lost the main road. The Glamfathans said we trespassed in the ruins. I don't believe that. Odima would never allow it. But as much as the fangs are hotheads, Glamfathans don't attack without being provoked. Either they saw something and got the wrong idea, or... She glances down the passage beyond. Or there's looters in here with us. That's not something we need right now. Okay, that's interesting. You know, I'm used to a lot of games just having bandits, you know, just attack you for no reason. But these guys actually have a reason for this. They're protecting their land, so they have a motive other than just... kill them and take their stuff. I kind of like that. What about everyone else in our caravan? Kalisha's lips press together and her chin rumples. Her voice is faint. The wheels got hold of them now. She looks up. Gods grant them better luck in their next lives. You don't seem too upset about all this. Kalisha looks you in the eye, a volatile current running beneath her voice. Maybe you just don't know me enough to know what upset looks like. And maybe I've seen worse, too. Seen worse and kept on walking, because there's nothing else to be done, and because there's other people you care about who still need you. Fair enough. Let's get going. What do you think? Archway or tunnel? This way. Anything to be seen? No. Let's try up here. Just for the hell of it, here's our map.
Someone else has been here. We should move.
Move away. But there's stuff. Camping supplies. Right. In amongst these supplies are bedrolls, blankets, rations, and other amenities intended to keep hardy explorers from succumbing to the elements. Mace. The bane of mailed soldiers throughout the known world, maces are a common sight in the Deerwood. Regardless of the shape of their flanges, maces always consist of a metal shaft topped with a number of symmetrical flanges that focus the weapon's power to a small point. Though estocks have even more penetrating power than maces, the latter can't be used in concert with a shield. I'm guessing so. I have no idea what an estoc is. Hammer and chisel. A simple iron hammer and chisel useful for chipping away at hard surfaces, particularly ones that display structural weakness. Huh. I wonder if we'll have cause to use it down here. You've discovered some camping supplies. You can use these to rest in the wilderness or dungeons, fully restoring all of your character's abilities and health. Easy difficulty allows you... 2, carry more camping supplies, but hard restricts them severely. If you fully run out of camping supplies, try to find an inn. Most have cheap rooms available. Did I take the chisel? No. Take that. There you go. Now, can we get encumbered in this game? I mean, I thought we were going to once I picked up all this crap. So now we have 2 camping. This is... currency. What kind of currency? I mean, what do we have? Silver pieces? Gold pieces? Hold on. Nope, we can't find out here. Okay. A small shield. Though they don't offer much protection, small shields do not interfere with the warrior's accuracy at all. Unlike larger shields, which are worn in the forearm, small shields are held in the hand. Oh, torch. Though not especially effective in combat, torches can be used to illuminate dark environments. Okay. Alright, guys. You stay tuned next time when we investigate past the archway. Thanks for watching. See you next time.